Welcome back, everybody. Oh, I see I'm starving here. That's not so good. So today what we're looking to do is replace all the buildcraft power with these type of pipes, but for power transmission in this mod pack, and that's going to stop overloading the system. But first of all, what we need is a magma crucible. So looking at this recipe, got nether bricks, got some of these things, so it's kind of a recipe you've seen me make before. I'm going to get that together and then I'll show you what I'm doing with it. So I've just put down the magma crucible. I'm going to put liquid redstone in there, and then we'll see what happens when we switch on the power downstairs. Because now we should have quite a bit that the system can do with that. How are we doing for temperature? 114 degrees, that's fine. This is working at 8 megajoules or Minecraft joules. Okay, so how's this doing? Okay, so it's burning it up, and what do we get out? Well, liquid redstone is what we'll have gathering in here, and I'm going to be using that for the next part, and I'll be back with you soon. I'm just going to let this melt up in here for a while. Okay, next up we want to make a liquid transposer. So not too bad a recipe. Again, the frames and redstone thing, all similar stuff you've seen before. I'm going to make this and I'll see you in a moment. Okay, I have my liquid transposer here. I'm just going to plug it in next to the crucible. We should see redstone's already been brought through from this machine directly into there. Okay, I'm just going to let them run through and I'll see you all in a bit. So I'm in a bit of a trouble with this setup I had down here where items... I had the full sawmill and there's more wood coming down and just spitting on the floor, so I have to redesign this little bit here. So that just should get it rotating around. It should be fine once it's running properly. At the moment, it's just got a lot to pass through to the system. That's causing the too many items coming down here at the moment. Okay, so that should be that sorted. Now, I was also having trouble up here with the barrels. In fact, I was having trouble with the barrel down here that once it had filled up the barrel once, it was having trouble adding more in, so I've put the pipe to the top and that seems to have sorted that problem out. But I think I'm going to have the same problem over here, and to do with the leaves, I was getting more leaves passed down to the sawmill that I couldn't deal with the sawmill. So I think I'm going to have to use diamond pipes to route some of that stuff around. It's a shame because I'm running low on diamonds. So I'm going to have to root the apples, the leaves out of the main pipe that passes down there, and I'm going to have to route them into the top of these barrels and probably set up a circular insertion thing to make sure they all get put in. So I'll get on with that and I'll speed you all in a bit. Okay, so I've redone the tubing around here, and I've had to use a diamond pipe just here There's 7 diamond pipes left over for other things in the future. You know, all this stuff is probably temporary anyway until I get a proper sorting system up and running and I've got an idea of what I want to do this series, but it's a little while away yet. That's working now okay. These barrels can only hold 64 times, so I'll probably need a void pipe somewhere around here at some point. Right, so that's... they'll either go into these or not and just cycle around until they do go into them. There's 50-50 chance of going in here, 50-50 chance of going in here, or going around once more. So hopefully we should see some of them storing in okay. Yeah, this is... it's not the best system, but it'll do. I suppose I could have these looping around separately to these, and they should get in quicker, but that's fine. It'll work. So there's a skeleton in that pool over there looking at me over the wall. So we've got quite a bit of the... oops. Oh, that's interesting. That turns them around, does it? Ah, didn't know that. So we have quite a bit of liquid redstone. Next up, we need some electrum ingots, and I think what we can do... get some of those that use silver and gold inside here. Let's see what we get. Okay, good. That's what we're after. Right, so with the electrum ingots, we put them like that and we get some energy conduits. We're going to need more than this. But this is just to show what I'm doing with this liquid redstone. So if we put that in here, we get these. If I just show that here. So these are going to replace all the gold piping in here, and we're no longer going to need this thing here. So I'm going to take those back. Definitely want all this stuff back. So just get rid of those. I've got plenty of wood at the moment. Okay, so I am going to make up some more of those. They're called energy conduits. They're without the liquid redstone in there. They are that energy conduit, empty redstone energy conduit. Anyway, I need to figure out how much I want down here, and I shall be back with you soon. Okay, well, I've finished off filling up these redstone energy conduits. Let's get these hooked up. Filled this area in down here now, so I don't need to. So I've removed the water from there. So we should be able to just turn all these on now. Okay, so these things won't explode, so that's a lot better. Hey everybody, welcome back. So things are going well down here. The boiler's now reached top temperature, nothing's exploded. Managed to just keeping the water there fine. I could be running a lot more of these steam engines than I currently am. Each of these barrels contains 64 of an item, and I've already filled up one of these with sawdust. The one at the back's already full. So that's filling up pretty quickly, really. See how we're doing down here. So that's going to be full pretty soon as well. I've also been out mining quite a lot, and you can see my chests are filling up. I'm going to have to get some proper storage set up, and that is what we're going to do next. We're going to have a look at Applied Energistics and the ME stuff. So the first thing I'm going to need is an ME controller. Looking at the recipe, that's an advanced processor. That's going to take a diamond. Silicon is quartz dust cooked up. And quartz cutting knife. It's just that pattern, and I've got plenty of both of those things. That should be good to get us going. Okay, so let's get on with this. We need an advanced processor. We need the silicon for that. We're going to need basic processors as well for some of the items. So we need a little bit of silicon. I'm going to get that cooking up now. Just going to get 16 of these to start with. Okay, let's see, what else do we need? So we need one of these. These are reusable tools. Let's grab some more out. Going to need a few of those as well. Some redstone for what we're up to. Okay, so let's get one of these. Just hope I've gathered enough quartz for what we have planned. Looks like it's already made the silicon. Okay, so need one of these. A diamond. Terrible job of remembering this recipe today. Okay, redstone. Okay, there's an advanced processor, and you can see the quartz cutting knife will last a little while. Okay, so then all we need to do with this is cook it up. So I'm going to need one ME controller. as a controller, and I was thinking I'm gonna have it just here. Stick a bit of wood in there for the time being. So I don't need to be able to access this from outside. Let's have a look. So you can see it takes power, and that's what we're going to hook up next. So I'm going to get those wires coming across here. So I'm just going to go under the stairs with this. So I should be able to hook it straight in through from there, up and around, and then above that is where the controller is. So I'm just going to get on with that off camera. I think I probably do need to make a few more wires, some more of these redstone energy conduits, but I'll do that off camera and get back to you soon. Okay, you can see now we're getting power, the screen light's on the side, and it's online. So next up we want some other ME stuff. So we're going to want ME drive eventually, but first of all we'll get the front stuff open or set up. So access terminal is needed to be able to see what's in the system. We need a crafting terminal to be able to craft things. Crafting monitor to make sure that whatever we ask to craft we've got all the items for. So I'm going to want all three of those, and they're going to be going around the front here. We'll have a little wall. Nice wooden surround. Must have used up the other axe. I thought I had another one somewhere. Oh well. So I'm just going to set those up there. Now, what's the recipe for these things? Let's start with the access terminal. We need some cabling. I'm going to need quite a bit of that anyway. Now the conversion matrix, it's not too bad. We need one of these. So we've got all that. So that's for that one. And a crafting terminal. So we'll need two access terminals to make that. And that's another one of those. And a crafting monitor. It's another one of those. Okay, so I'm gonna get on with those three items, and I shall see you in a little while. Oh, hang on. Because I'm gonna be coming back to. We need to know how to make these cables anyway, because I'm going to be using that to connect some of these devices up. So that's quartz fiber and some redstone, and the quartz fiber is just glass surrounded by quartz dust, or dust around the quartz. Glass around the quartz dust. Okay, because there's four of those, which possibly is enough for what I've got in mind. Anyway, let's make that. So this cabling is used to connect all the various bits and pieces together. Where's my glass? So all the items from Applied Energistics can be connected with these cables, as well as being placed beside each other. this is how I'm going to connect up from here to my other machines. Just like that, and then I'll be able to, because these ones are going to be beside each other, they'll run fine. Okay, so next up we need, it was 4 of these, so not too bad. And again, that needs to be cooked. Is there anything I can get on with while I'm waiting for that to cook? Access terminal, pretty much there with what we need. Right. These, one of them is for the crafting. So we need 2 of these. Remember, one of them is for the crafting terminal. So let's plug in that. Okay, so this will give us access to everything in the system. You can tell that that is connected in. This will tell us what's connected, and also that would be grayed out if it wasn't receiving power or wasn't connected up to a controller. So that's all working nicely. So next up we want a crafting monitor. Ah, we need some more of that wire. Crafting monitor, and we'll also create the crafting terminal. So you do go through all the components pretty quickly at this stage, but you know, I've been out mining quite a lot. I've got a lot of the stuff I needed anyway. So there's a crafting terminal, so we're going to need one of these. It goes through a lot of iron as well, but I've got tons of it. So that is the crafting terminal. I'm going to put that there. Crafting monitor. Now, crafting terminal does come with a separate crafting space here. Starting to look pretty cool. I'm going gonna have to think about doors and windows soon. I'm getting quite a few spiders. I'm sure, probably shown you that in a previous video, but there's quite a few spiders like to hang out around here. Okay, next up we need a way to store items in here. So we could connect up these wires to type of device is it? Storage bus attached to any chest or barrels, and that would connect into the system with these type of wires. So we've got everything connected properly. Or we can use the ME drives, and we can then place in the ME drives some of these storage things. Now, some of them are quite expensive, like this one here, and there's lots of components. Each of these is a diamond, like the blue ones. So for 64k storage, you're looking at one diamond, two diamonds, so that's four diamonds for 64k storage. 16k is probably close to what I can manage at the moment. Or that's one diamond. Or I might go for, yeah, I might go for a few of those 16k storages. That's the amount of items that it can store. And anyway, before we get on with that, I need an ME drive. And that's a couple more of these things. Okay, so I'm gonna get on with the ME drive. And I'm gonna make a few of these. 16k storage. Not the 64k. So quite a few steps to get that made. So I'm going to get on with that, and I shall be back with you in a little while. Did I say also I'm gonna create this thing? Yeah, I did. Okay, so I'm gonna get on with that and I'll be back with you in a little while. Okay, so I'm back and I've got some components here. Now, I thought you'd be interested to see, for two of these 16k storages, I've had to use two of these, which is using a diamond. 24 of these. I thought you'd be interested in the quantities we're using here, because that's quite a serious amount of resources at this stage in the game for me. So we've got those so you can see there's quite a bit to put together for this. I'll be back with you in a little while. There's one. Okay, let's plug this in down here. And I've got a choice. I think I'll just leave it there. Plug this in. Okay, now provided we have power, we're always going to be able to access items in here. From here. So we can start storing items away, and you'll see that they stack up quite nicely. And we can search. Okay, so that's pretty much the storage system. Get in there, I'm going to need some more iron. Not sure what that block is doing in the air. It attracts my attention every so often. Okay, let's make another one of these then. So need 9 of these. Hopefully I have enough quartz. Don't think I do. Whenever you see the quartz downstairs, make sure you mine it up, because I'm going to have to go on another mining trip now. So let's go down here and have a look at this now. 274 of quite a bit used up, 16k. See how much it can take. Going to hold masses of stuff, is it? Well, that's not too bad. So these 16k ones will do me for a little while. You probably want to keep on the outside is tools, because if you do run out of power, you can't access anything in these terminals. Just something to bear in mind. Right, I'm off mining for a little bit more quartz, and I'll probably move these chests across. And then we'll have a look at some of the simple crafting stuff we can do. I suppose I should start using this now. Actually, we don't need a chest, but we might need some sticks. So you can see it's taking it directly at the inventory, and that's what it's going to be quite useful with. The system. So I can use that crafting terminal there to be able to craft directly from the inventory that's attached to it. So quite a handy thing. So much power are we drawing now? So only 12 units per tick being taken. Each of these are given out 8 Minecraft joules per tick, so we're fine on power at the moment, but I probably want to start expanding these engines as I start expanding the system up here. What's the light on the back here? Ooh. Maybe I don't want to store that down there. Maybe I want that up there so I can keep an eye on it. So I think that tells us how much storage it's got left. Maybe those two bars. Think about it. Anyway, I'm off mining. I'll see you all in a bit. Hi guys, welcome back. So I've started transferring everything across. I'm keeping it outside. Few items, all the tools and all that kind of stuff that I'm not going to store in the system. You see, we've got quite a lot stored in there now. But I can't store any more in there, so this is after my mining trip. So I'm up to, well, I can store one other item in there. So now it's at 63 of 63 types on both of these. So these devices store 63 items, or different types of items, but then the number of bytes, the 16K storage, is to do with the number of, or the stack size of those items. So I still need a little bit more storage, and to keep myself going, I'm probably going to build two of these 4K storages just to finish off filling it up with what I've got in my inventory, and gives a little bit of space for growing. Did find quite a lot of quartz when I went off mining. It's tough to find, so that did take quite a while. But yeah, so I'm going to finish up that off camera, and we'll call it an end to the episode here, because it's been quite a long episode. Next time I'm going to start looking at how to connect up these machines to the system so that we automatically start processing ore, and you can see that I've started storing ore in here so that I can work on that. So I'm going to be looking to how we process ore automatically, how we cook it. Right, so I think we'll call it an end to the episode there. Thank you for watching, everybody, and I shall see you next time.